Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can use the Commando framework to easily create commands. Now in my opinion, this is the best way to create commands, and throughout this series I've showed you a couple different custom ways in order to create commands, and those are useful for learning purposes, but whenever you're actually creating a real bot, you're going to want to try and use the Commando framework when possible. So here I have this project, and a link to the GitHub repository that will have this project will be in the video description. And real quick before we start, if you do need help with anything, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the Warren Off Keys Discord, and I'll be sure to help you if you post in either of those two places. So with that said, let's get started. So to start off, we want to be able to know where the documentation is for Commando. So going into Chrome, we can actually go to the Discord.js documentation. You can easily find this on Google. A link to this will also be in the video description. And we see at the top here, view docs for main library. Clicking on this dropdown, we can then select Commando. We're referring to some of these things from time to time, and it's important that you know where the documentation is. Just in case you get stuck or you don't know all the features Commando offers, you can go through and navigate through this, and we'll be checking into this from time to time throughout this video. Next, we want to actually install this. Now, typically whenever you're going to be installing something, you're going to be using npm install and then the name. And I wouldn't run this command, but for example, it would be npm install discord.js-commando, like it says right here at the bottom. Now, the problem with this is if we go to Google and we search up discord.js commando, this is going to be a failing build. So what is hosted here on the npm repository is not going to be a working version. So we do not want to install this. However, a working version is on their GitHub repo, which is github.com/discordjs/commando. And so a link to this will be in the video description. So we can actually just copy this and we can install from the GitHub repo directly just by saying npm install and then the GitHub link. So I can then run that. Now going back into our code here, discordjs actually extends the functionality of the current Discord client. So we're no longer going to import discord.js and create a client like we are here on line 3 and 4. So I'm going to comment these out. Instead, we are going to import commando. So const commando equals require discord.js-commando. Now, after I've imported this right here above our client.onReady, I'm going to create a new client. So const client equals new commando.commando. Client. So within here, we're going to pass in an object, and these are going to be some properties that is going to specify some information here. So the first one will be owner, and this is going to be our user's ID. Going into Discord, I can right click on my user and click copy ID. If you don't see this, you have to enable developer mode on your Discord account, and then paste that in here. Then we can pass in a command prefix. And for those who've been following along, you understand that that is within the config JSON. So I can simply just say config.prefix. So scrolling down, we see that we are calling commandbase.loadPrefixes and also loading the commands. We want to go ahead and comment that out. And then right below our client is ready, we're going to go through and register some commands. So if we navigate into the Commando framework, we see at the top here, commands, built-in commands. I can click on this and we're going to see some built-in commands. We have a help command, a ping command, a prefix command, which will allow you to configure per server guild prefixes. And so that's something we'll be covering in this video as well. But with that said, we're going to start off by just simply registering those. And we can do that by accessing the Commando client. So client, and then we want to access registry, which is going to allow us to register different commands. And then we can say register defaults. We can call this function and I'm going to save the file. Going into my console here, I can run our code with node index.js. So here we see we're enabling all of our features. However, we're not enabling any of the commands because I commented those out. So everything within our commands directory is completely ignored. Going back into the documentation, we see that ping is a predefined command here. So we can try that out. Exclamation point ping. And it'll say pong, the message round trip took this many milliseconds. The heartbeat ping took this many milliseconds. So we also have access to exclamation point help. So this is from Commando itself. This is not any of my commands. So that means that we have now registered our default commands correctly. So we have our commands folder here, and I'm actually going to make a new folder called commands spelled like this. And this is where I'm going to host all of the new commands we're going to write with the Commando framework. Now, in order to actually register those, we can simply say dot register commands in. And then we have to, let me minimize the console here. Within here, we have to pass in the actual path for commands. Now to do this, we have to use the path package. And so right up here, I'm going to import that. This is something that Node.js comes with, so there's no need to install it. So constant path equals require path. Then scrolling back down, we can now pass in path.join. We're going to have the first argument be our current directory absolute path, which is underscore underscore dir name. And then afterwards, we're going to say commands. Now it's going to import all the files from our commands directory and try and register those as commands. So within this video, I'm going to show you how you can make an add command and a kick command. So I'm going to make two folders in here. One will be called misc, and the other one is going to be called moderation. Oops, there we go. Okay, so misc and moderation are both within the commands directory. And now we want to register the commands as certain groups. So to do that, I can say dot register groups. Make sure that there's an S here. I'm going to take in an array. Now within here, this is actually going to be an array of arrays. And so each array is going to have the name of the group and then a group description. So let's say that for misc, which is where our add command will live, we can say misc as the name of the group and then misc commands. Now the second array is going to be moderation. And then the description will be moderation commands. We can save this. So at this point, we don't have any commands, so nothing actually happens. But I'm going to go inside of the misc directory, and I'm going to make a new file called add.js. Now within here, we have to import commando. So constant commando equals require discord.js-commando. Now we're going to want to export a class. And if you don't know what classes are or what object-oriented programming is, I would highly suggest you look into it. I'm not going to be explaining it in this video because it's outside the scope of this. But understanding object-oriented programming will definitely help you in the long run as a programmer. So here we can actually export this, so module.exports, and we're going to create a new class. This will be called addCommand. And this class is going to extend the functionality of another class. So we can say extends, and the class we want to extend the functionality of is going to be the commando command. So we can say commando, which is the object we're actually importing, dot command. So this is going to be another class that is going to have its own functionality that we're looking to extend within our new class called addCommand. So we can have an opening set of curly braces. So now we have to do something with the actual class constructor. And to put it simply, if you don't know, a constructor is something that is going to be ran whenever a class is used, and essentially it's going to help us with some setup. So that's a very basic description there. So we can type in constructor, and this is going to be a function. This function will have one argument, which will be client. Now within here, we need to call the constructor for the commando.command class. Now, in order to call a constructor of a class that you are extending, you can call super. Now within here, we need to pass in some other information. So the first argument will be the client. The second argument will be an object here, which will be some options. So the first one will be the name of the command, which is add. The second one will be the group it belongs to, which is misc. Third one will be the member name, which will be add again. Then we have the description, which will be adds numbers together. So now we have this information here, but in order to actually run the command, we need to set up a new function. So down here, you have to make this an asynchronous function that is called run. And if we look inside of the documentation real quick, again, that this is the commando command class. We can then see under classes, we have command right here. So clicking on that, so scrolling down, we see our methods and we see run. So if I click on this, we see that this runs the command and we have a number of different arguments that we can actually access. And we have to have at least the message here in order to make functional commands. So the first argument we're going to listen to is message. Now here, this is going to be a standard message with some additional functionality. So if we look here, this is a type of commando message. So if I open this in a new tab here, we're going to see that this extends message, which is the type of message we've been using throughout this entire series, but there's additional functionality in here. I'm not going to cover the exact details of what's different within this video. We're essentially just going to use this as a typical message. So to make sure that this works, I can say console.log message.content. And so if you've been following the series, you know that this is going to be the exact text that is actually sent as the message. So I can save this and we can restart our bot. Going into Discord, I can then run add 10 and 5. We see in our console, add 10 and 5, which is the content of the actual message. So that means that our command is registered correctly. Now, the Commando framework is going to have better ways of handling the arguments, so we don't have to manually go through and individually get the 10 and the 5 as their own separate variables. So if we look inside the documentation, we see that the second argument is called args, and so we can go ahead and add that in as well. And then I'm going to console log that right here. So if I save this, I can then go into Discord and I can do add. So saving this, I can then restart my bot and then go back into Discord and I can do add 10 and 5. And we now see add 10 and 5, but we also see the arguments. Now this is going to be within a single string. And in some use cases, that's going to make sense. In this use case, we don't want that. So going back into our options here, we can add in something called args type. And by default, it'll be single, which means all of the arguments are going to be set inside of their own single string. But if we want there to be multiple arguments that we can use, we can then type multiple. And so if you want to know how I found this information, if we go inside of the documentation, we can scroll all the way up. We see that under our command, we have our client, which we are passing in right here. But then we have the second object. And so going back to the documentation, that is called the command info. So clicking on the type right here, would then be able to see all the information. So you can go through and read the descriptions of these. We're going to be using some of these soon. And scrolling down, we see args type. So this says one of single or multiple. Only applicable if args is not specified. When single, the entire argument string will be passed in to run as one argument. When multiple, it will be passed in as multiple arguments. So this will be within an array. Now this column right here, we scroll all the way up, we see that this is the default value. So scrolling back down to args type, the default value is single. So we actually want to change this to multiple like we do right here, and we're going to see a difference. So if I save this, going into the bot, it's currently one single string. If I were to restart this, and if I were to go into Discord and run add 10 and 5, we then see it is now an array. We can also add in as many numbers as we want. So add 5, 10, 15. And then it's going to have an array right here. So let's actually go ahead and implement the functionality for this. Now that we have an array within arguments, we can actually loop through that. So I'm going to say let sum equals 0. We're using let here because this variable is actually going to change. And then we can loop through all of the arguments. So for const arg of args. And then within here, I'm going to say sum is plus equal to parse int of arg. There's a couple different ways you could do this. You can do sum is plus equal to plus arg, which is one way that I've been doing things throughout this series, is putting a plus before a variable, which will convert it to an int. However, it's not the most readable thing, so I'm going to opt in for this syntax, which is parse int. It'll simply do the same thing. It's going to convert argument into a number. If we look into the console, these are actually strings because they are surrounded by single quotes, and so we want to actually convert that to a number and then add that to sum. Finally, I can say message.reply. Template literal, the sum is, and then I can pass in sum. So saving this and restarting the bot, I can then go back and I can run add 5, 10, 15. And it's going to say the sum is 30. Ignore this, this is from something else. So I can then run add 5 and 5. It says the sum is 10. And so everything seems to be working here. So if you've been following the series, you might also have an error in here. This has something to do with one of the features. A quick fix for now is I'm just going to comment out load features because we don't need to deal with those within this video. So now we see there's no more errors. And if I were to run add 5 and 10, everything works as expected. Okay, so next we're going to create a kick command. And so going inside of moderation, I can make a new file called kick.js. This is going to be set up in a very similar way. Now I'm going to drag our add.js over to the right panel over here. Now it's important that you don't just copy and paste this and edit it. It's important that we go through and actually type this out so it becomes easier for you to remember in the future. So const commando equals require discord.js-commando. And then here we can export a new class. So module.exports equals class. we'll say kick command. This is going to extend commando.command. So then we have our curly braces, and then we have our constructor function with our client object. Now within here, we can call super. We're going to pass in our client, and we're going to have our options. The name is going to be kick. The group will be moderation. The member name will be kick. Our description will be kicks a member from the Discord server. Now in this case, we don't care about args type. We do care about some permissions. And so if we look inside of the documentation here, we can scroll up and we see client permissions and user permissions. So we want to actually implement these. So I can say client permissions, and this is going to require the bot to have these permissions. It's going to be an array of strings, and this will be kick members. You can obviously add in as many different permissions as you want, but in this case, we're just going to keep it simple with that. We also want the user permissions, and this will make sure that the user who actually is running this command will have access to the kick members permission as well. So now random people can't actually go through and kick people within your Discord, which is obviously a good thing. Now we want to actually use our run function, so async run. We're going to have our message object. Now, similar to the previous kick command that I've made, we want to actually gain access to the first mention. So I can say const target equals message.mentions.users.first. And then I can say if not target, which means that they did not tag someone, we can then complain to the user in a similar way. So message.reply, please specify someone to kick, and then we can return. Now below this, we know that we have the ability to kick someone. However, this is going to return a user object. So going into the documentation, if I scroll all the way up and I go back into the main library, we could do a search for user. And scrolling down, we see user right here. This is going to be something where we don't actually have access to a kick function. We only have access to what we have right here. So we need to gain access to a guild member object. And if we go down, we can find guild member. Clicking on this, we do have access to a kick function. So with that said, we simply just need to gain the guild member from the guild user's ID. It's actually fairly simple to do. The first thing we need is access to the actual guild for this message. So we can destructure that from the message object. And then I can say const member equals guild.members.cache. .get, and then we can pass in the actual user ID. Now the user ID and the member ID are going to be the same, so we can simply just say target.id. So now at this point, we want to actually kick the member, but going into Chrome here, we see we have this different properties. We see bannable, and we also see kickable. So clicking on this, it says whether this member is kickable by the client user, which is our bot. So going back, we can say if member.kickable, and this is essentially going to say, can this bot actually kick this member? Because a bot cannot kick someone who is going to have a higher role than the bot. So if it is kickable, we can then say member.kick and then message.reply, that user has been kicked. And then an else statement here, we can just simply say message.reply, I cannot kick that user. Now I can go ahead and save this and we can restart our bot. Okay, so I just invited a test account, or a test bot rather. Now I can try kicking them, so exclamation point kick. It's going to say, please specify someone to kick. I can say exclamation point kick test. It says the same thing. Then exclamation point kick at dummy account. And we see that they actually left right there, and it says that user has been kicked. Now if I try and kick the tutorial bot, it'll say, I cannot kick that user. And so now we have a working add command and a working kick command using the Commando framework. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.